Well, I'm back a little sooner than expected. Poor financial decisions happened. Let's talk about some more records, baby! So, if you haven't seen any of my other videos, I got quite the collection. But as you can see, there's still some space in this bin. So, I had to fill it out, and there were a couple albums I was gonna just wait for and maybe get like some other time, like Christmas. But I honestly had a pretty good amount of money stockpiled. I'm not spending as much as I thought I would be up here. So hopefully this wasn't a bad idea. I guess only time will tell. But I got four new records. I'm very excited to talk about them. I'm just gonna go with these from the order of the release, so the ones that were released, most in the past, coming all the way up to the present. We got a pretty good spread of years right now. I think a 21-year gap. That's older than me. Speaking of older than me is this first album, Vaudeville Villain by Victor Vaughn. Cats tried to cut us off by the garage. When V pulled out the Nicky, I like chances slim like Lionel Richie. There's no finer sound than when you let off a 9 round. Before the slug find the ground, V be in Chinatown. Give me a slew of M80s, a cardinal of those chases, and two of them ladies. Coming out in 2003. This is the first album. Actually, no, this is the second album MF Doom put out under a different moniker. I want to say Take Me to Your Leader came out first. I'm not fully sure. But this is like an actual full album. Take Me to Your Leader is kind of like compilation-ish. But man, oh man, this one, it's a lot darker, in my opinion, than just like, Umfood especially, or Operation Doomsday. Mad Villainy does have some of the more like, I guess you could say, a little darker tone of the production, but this album really takes the cake as far as the Doom albums I own. I know Born Like This also has a lot of darker production, but I'm not as crazy about that one. This, on the other hand, I mean, you got peak Doom. From like, 1999 to what, 2005, Doom was just out here killing shit. So, he's in his prime right now, rap-wise. The production's really cool on this thing. There's a lot of like sci-fi stuff. Again, darker, but it still feels like a Doom record, if that makes sense, even though it's not produced by him. But yeah, just really great, lyrical rap. My top three songs, if you haven't seen any of these videos, I probably should have said this earlier, I always give my three favorite songs, and then I give my least favorite songs. So actually, I'm going to start with my least favorite, and so I have two answers. The one answer is just normally, songs I don't pick out. It's either the open mic nights. I didn't really count those as skits, even though they pretty much are, just because, there actually is, like, rapping on it. I mean, it's pretty much just, like, stereotyping rappers at the time, which, yeah, it's kind of funny, but I'm not going back to them that much. And then for this vinyl version, first of all, you saw this already, but nice silver record. Oh, it looks super nice. The last song, Change the Beat, which, on Spotify, it's, like, Untitled, a.k.a. Change the Beat. The first part of it, which, I mean, it's normally just, like, the little outro that says, and then Victor Vaughn disappeared forever, or whatever. And then there's, like, 2.5 minutes of rain sounds. It's not on here! Where the fuck is my rain sounds? I'm not gonna say that I even revisit that track that much, but just for the full album listen through, maybe just because I'm used to, listening to it on the phone. But it feels a little weird just to cut off the song before. I think it was GMC. I'm already forgetting the track list. Yeah, GMC, I'm not an idiot. It cuts from that and then instantly gets into the rapping part of Change the Beat, which it feels a little disjointed. But I mean, it is what it is. Still a great record. There's not really any bad songs on here, but my top three, I'd have to say are Can I Watch? I'd have to say are Lactose and Lecithin, and I'd have to say are Never Dead. Can I Watch is just a great little, like, kind of back and forth song, lovey-dovey, very chill beat, probably the chillest beat on this album. And it's Vic, well, I was about to say Doom, but Victor Vaughn, and then this girl, Nikki, just got some great back and forth verses, where they, like, meet, kind of start falling in love, and then how that kind of falls apart and all that, and then that leads to the song getting its name from her saying she'd rather masturbate than fuck with Vic Vaughn. And of course, being the opportunistic young man he is, Vic has to ask, can he watch? Lactose and Lecithin is one of my favorite beats on this album, aside from Can I Watch, which I was just raving about. Very, very, like, sci-fi kind of spaceship sounding, and there even is the one part, I don't know which song I'm showing you guys. It could be any of these three, honestly. But, I mean, there's a part where he's talking about hyperdrive. Got some great bars on there. The last song on there is Never Dead. That's one of the funniest concepts to me in this album. I think they pulled it off really well. It's pretty much Doom and then M. Syed as Curtis Streifer. So Vic and Curtis are pretty much, you know, getting into some shit at school because someone stole Doom's Donkey Kong game out of his locker. Classic stuff. Got some great, like, you know, back and forth verses. Not like back and forth, but, you know, like one verse goes into another perfectly well. All of that, but yeah. Vaudeville Villain. All right, the second album, we have a 13-year jump from 2003 up to 2016. And this is actually a mixtape, it's not an album. I don't know if this is an official release, but it's one of my favorites of all time, and that is Purple Rain by Future. I just need my girlfriend. I just need my girlfriend. I just need... Hope I didn't come at you the wrong way, that wasn't planned. Hope you seen the path that I made. I took a chance. Boom. All right, first things first, this was my first Future project I ever listened to. I didn't get onto SoundCloud until like late 2015, early 2016. So, you know, like my sixth grade year of school pretty much. And I remember pretty early on, one of my friends put me onto the title track, Purple Rain. That's still one of my favorite songs, one of my most streamed songs ever. I love that shit. You'll hear me talk more about it later. And, you know, went back, listened to it. I was like, hey, that's not bad. As far as trap goes, you know, Future, he's definitely one of my favorites. I'd say, like, him and Travis are probably up there for kind of similar reasons. I just feel like they're really good at, like, catching a vibe. But Future also just flows his ass off sometimes. So, I mean, overall, front to back, this is a great, great mixtape. If I had to choose one weak song, it would be Bye Bye. And that's mainly just because I feel like his flow stagnates too much. Future is always someone who I love because he can find these pockets in the beats and he just really kills it like no one else can. But this song, he's just kind of doing the same flow with the da-da ending where it's like either Bye Bye or like, oh, she's shy, shy, or like just a bunch of shit. So it kind of stagnates. Still not a bad song, but just out of all the other songs on the track list, pretty mid. My three favorite songs, I mean the first one, as I said, of course, Purple Rain, the title right here, the title track. One of the like first songs I remember listening to on a streaming service. That beat is just otherworldly, instantly takes me into the vibe as soon as that first kick comes in. Got some great verses from Future. One of my favorite vocal performances from him on this album too. I feel like sometimes his voice can be a little shaky, but he got it on this one. The second song is the song right after it, News or Something. One of my favorite flows Future's ever done. He kind of reused this flow on Evil with Fly Shit Only, but I actually kind of like it more here, even though I like the Fly Shit Only beat more. News or Something beat's still great, but I mean, he's just flowing his ass off on it. And then the final song, it's got to be Perky's Calling. Now, you guys are probably going to be a little mad because you see Perky's Calling, Purple Rain, News or Something. The last three songs on this, I don't know what he did, why he backloaded this album so much. Like, there's great songs. All Right and Never Forget, the first two songs are amazing. All Right goes hard. Never Forget's got some of the more, like, I guess, heartfelt Future lyrics on this album. Really, you know, looking back on his past and his regrets and all that. But I don't know, man. It's something about just that somber piano. Future's got a nice, like, steady flow throughout. And again, he also is kind of touching on, like I said, and Never Forget. Just some of the stuff that, like, you know, he went through coming up and how he, luckily, doesn't have to keep doing that. So, Purple Rain, Purple Rain, Purple Rain. All right, moving up another 2 years. We're getting closer and closer. 2018. This is one of the best albums I feel like to come out of that time. And this is Daytona by Pusha T. I'm back in this hit, nigga. You ever seen Shark Tank? I paid him in small bills, all of them small face. I bet when we draw blood, you niggas will draw blank. Crush you in all black, partner with all saints. I'm numbers, it's all facts. My shooters get all thanks and all praise. So, this album, I'll admit, I actually didn't get into this album until he dropped It's Almost Dry in, what, 2021? That album's great. I like that one. Not as much as this one, though, because this album, it's a short 7 songs, just short and sweet, straight to the point. There's literally no filler, so this was the hardest one for me to really think about what my least favorite track is. But, you know, as far as, like, that kind of coke rap, like, K kingpin rap goes, I think Pusha T's on another level. His wordplay isn't double entendres. He's just got a really cool voice as well. I feel like people don't talk about that much. The yeah, I can't do it that well, but I love that ad lib too. But yeah, as I was saying, it was kind of hard for me to find a weak track on this album because there's not a lot of empty space on here. The one track I did decide to choose out, and this is going to be kind of crazy. So first of all, this whole album is produced by Kanye himself. But the one song that's my least favorite is the one that actually features him, and that's What Would Meek Do featuring Kanye West. And the main reason why I think it's my least favorite is the beat is one of the bottom tier beats for me. It's either that or Infrared, in my opinion. But what saves Infrared from not being my bottom is his verse is amazing on that very long, just, you know, sprawling verse, talking his shit to Cash Money and Young Money. What would Meek do? It kind of seems like a prelude to that. Like, he's kind of getting at the ideas of, like, the beef, but I think Infrared was better. You know, Pusha's definitely got some way better verses on this album. My three favorite songs, though, are gotta be Santeria, gotta be Comeback Baby, and gotta be The Games We Play. The Games We Play is one of my favorite beats on this album. I love that sample chop.
And here's my amazing rendition of said sample chop.
And Push just flows so effortlessly over it. A lot of great lines on there as well. A lot of great lines all over this album. It's just something you come to expect with Push. The next song, Comeback Baby, goes super, super hard. One of my favorite songs to play in the car. And I do like the little juxtaposition between, like, the sample used as kind of a chorus, and then as soon as the rapping comes back in, it's only a bass. It's pretty much only bass. Goes ballistic. Again, great bars. And then, what'd I say? Santeria. I'm forgetting. Santeria. Honestly, the first half, the beat's, like, not bad. The beat's not bad. I love 070 Shake's chorus. The first two verses are great, but that's the last verse, you know, when you get to the second half of the beat and it kind of switches up. That shit's so good. I like Push over a more like kind of sinister sounding, more devious sounding beat. In the first half of the song, it's a little more like, yay, yay. That's at least the vibe I get from the beat. You know, I'm not saying Push is like all happy and mighty. He's rapping about pretty much paying for a hit because one of his close friends died. Not the happiest subject, but, you know, song's great. Good album. All right, coming up on the last album. This album actually came out this year, 2024. And, coincidentally, it is my favorite album to come out this year. This album right here is Dark Times by Vince Staples. It's hard to sleep when you're the only one living the dream. Hard to leave niggas hanging when you the money tree. Something about the gutter that make us hate each other. Had to bury my older brother and humble me. Now, Vince is an artist that I've never been, like, super crazy on. I'm not going to lie. Like, I've heard Big Fish Theory, I've heard FM, and then I heard, what's the one that has Lil Fade and the other song? I think that's the self-titled one. So, I've heard some Vince. I mean, he's always good. He's a great rapper. But, I don't know. Something about this album, I feel like it just got me at a good time. Or maybe a bad time, because the album's called Dark Times. Bars. But I mean, it's a more somber, definitely more somber album. Very introspective. Vince Reno, like, I love his pen game, man. I love his pen, honestly. This album got me back into some Vince, for sure. But I mean, just super strong album front to back. Another one that was kind of hard for me to choose a least favorite. But if I had to choose my least favorite, it would be Children's Song. The main reason I'm saying Children's Song is I just don't really like that beat much. I'm not going to lie. The beat's kind of goofy. Like, the guitar sample feels a little weird. Vince's rapping on it's great. But, you know, I really have to nitpick on an album like this. But yeah, man. But for my top three, I'm going to have to choose Government Cheeses. It's going to be Etouffee, and it's going to be Little Homies. Little Homies is the more, like, I think this is the most upbeat song on this album. Maybe Black and Blue's a little upbeat. But that's more just, like, the instrumental. This one, you know, he's talking about life hard, but it go harder. Life hard, but it go harder. It's got a nice little groove to it. You know, I could see you playing this at, like, a little function in the car. The next song, Government Cheeses, has one of my favorite verses from him on it in the second verse. Just very introspective from Vince, really letting you into his mind and his personal mental struggles. Great beat as well. And then Etouffee, it is the longest song on this album. It is a pretty short album. It's only one LP. It's about like 40 minutes long. This is one of those songs you actually get three verses out of Vince. All really great verses. He's kind of just, I'm not going to like fully go into it because, I probably am not the best person to tell you about it. But he's pretty much just talking about struggles with the streets, leaving the streets, all the stuff that comes with that. And I mean, again, I feel like Vince, he's just got a very mature pen for someone who you might see in like interviews and podcasts and stuff. He seems like a kind of goofy dude, but he's like a serious type of goofy, and he gets really serious on this album, but it's still really great. If you haven't heard it, I really recommend you check it out. And yeah, that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hope it wasn't too enjoyed for you guys. Hopefully, I put you onto some music. Put me onto some music down below. Let me know if you have any records. Let me know what you got. What's your favorite album right now? All of that. But that's about it for me. I hope you enjoyed watching. Thank you very much for watching the end. And it's Big Dunk. I feel like I'll be seeing you pretty soon. Peace.